Good morning, brothers and sisters. Today, we in the Assembly of God, Kandy, are going to focus on God's love on the family and very specially on the mother. Mothers are important. There's a saying, the hand that rocks the cradle rules the world. Would you bow your head in prayer with me as we ask God's blessing on the entire service today? Father, we come before you right now in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for this opportunity that we have to gather together as families, as friends, as loved ones, across this city, across this nation. Lord, we want to thank you for the opportunity to gather together, to worship you together, to bless your name, to lift your name, to touch you, and at the same time have a divine touch from heaven itself. Lord, we pray that your continued presence would be with us throughout this time, even as we gather and worship, and as we hear God's servant bring the word. We pray, Lord, that the word would penetrate our hearts, and it would find a dwelling place in the hearts and lives of all the people who would hear this word. We ask, Lord, that your continued presence would be with us in Jesus' name. Amen.
Good morning, everyone. It's good to be back in the feet of God this morning. As we all get gathered together at homes to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, wherever you are, make sure that you give the glory to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, because He is worthy of all our praises. He is worthy of all what we can give it to Him. This morning, as a family, be in the feet of God as we start singing and worshiping and lifting the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Clap your hands wherever you are. Stand on your feet and worship the God, because He is worthy of all the praises. Hallelujah.
Oh Lord,
Thou art worthy, my Lord. Thou art worthy of all the praises. Thou art worthy of all the honor. Thou art worthy, Lord Jesus, this morning. As we come before your throne and offer our life to you, we pray, Jesus, that you touch us, Father, this morning. Holy Spirit, make us new this morning. As we commit as a family into your presence, under your feet, Lord, I pray, one more time, another day, help us to be obedient and come as a family to serve you, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Jesus, hallelujah. Oh, we worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Let him take control our life this morning. Hallelujah. Lord. We thank you, Lord. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you, Lord, for wonderful things that you are doing in our lives. We thank you, Lord, for your grace. We thank you, Lord, for your love. We thank you, Lord, for your compassion. We thank you, Lord, for the blood that you shed on the cross. We thank you, Lord, for all what you have done in our life, Lord. We commit all things into your precious hands. In the name of Jesus, we pray.
Church, good to be in the house of the Lord this morning. And though we can't meet in the building, we can meet as one family through WhatsApp and Facebook. We are able to link with all of y'all, and we are so happy that you could join us this morning in our service. We could worship the Lord, and let's take a few moments to meditate on His word this morning, because I believe God has called each one of us for such a time as this, because God has something very special and unique planned for each one of us, and especially for our families. You know, we are talking about spiritual families, and last week we spoke about Joshua, who made a choice. He said, as for me and my family, we will serve the Lord. You know, your decision will determine your destiny. Your decision as a family will determine the destiny of your family. The decision of the church will determine the destiny of the nation. And I think it's a time that we make decisions aligning ourselves with the truth, which is the word of God. Because that is going to bring us success and prosperity. That's what the word says. Meditate on my word day and night so that you will have success. You know, in times like this, it's easy to look at everything else and allow all the other noises or the voices we hear to govern our thinking and our choices. But church, today you and I are privileged. We can listen to God's word and we can be blessed. I want to share a portion of scripture taken from Exodus chapter 2, reading from verse 1 to 3. It says, now a man of the house of Levi married a Levite woman, and she became pregnant and gave birth to a son. When she saw that he was a fine child. She hid him for 3 months. But when she could hide him no longer, she got a papyrus basket for him and coated it with tar and pitch. Then she placed the child in it and put it among the reeds along the bank of the Nile. Shall we bow our hearts in prayer? Our gracious, loving Heavenly Father, we come into your holy presence this morning. And we, Lord, we thank you that we could, Lord, listen to your word. Lord, we pray that you speak to our hearts. Holy Spirit, even as we meditate on this word, help us to, Lord, make choices and align our lives in accordance to your word, so that, Lord, we can receive your glory. We can receive your blessing. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Today, God has a special plan and a purpose for your family. You know, this story is told about a Levite named Amram. And he had a wife who was also a Levite. And they had a child. And they hid this child in a time when there was so much of death around them, just like now. You know, there was a decree that all the children under the sons under the age of 2 were to be killed. They were thrown into the Nile and crocodiles came and destroyed them and ate them up. But this mother, she knew that there was something special in her child's life. You know, parents, mothers especially, there is something unique about your children. There is something special. God has a divine plan and a purpose. And you need to understand that. And this mother chose to protect the child. Remember, the hand that rocks the cradle rules the world. The hand that rocks the cradle rules the world. And this mother, she chose to protect her child. In Numbers chapter 26 and verse number 59, it says there, the name of Amram's wife was Jochebed, a descendant of Levi, who was born to the Levites in Egypt. To Amram, she bore Aaron, Moses, and their sister Miriam. 3 children. Aaron became the priest for the nation of Israel. And we see Moses becoming the great leader to bring out almost 2 million people out of bondage to the promised land. And Miriam was an obedient daughter. This mother, she had a great impact. And the word Jochebed means Jehovah's glory. She was able to bring God's glory in her family. She was able to glorify God's name through her family. Church, that is what God wants to do through your family this day. Those are the decisions that we take. Let's look at this life. What did she first do? She hid the child for 3 months. That's what the Bible says. A woman of great wisdom. A woman who decided. You know, in Proverbs chapter 31, from verse 10 to 31, a virtuous woman's characters are given there. You know, this virtuous woman is likened to wisdom. And let's read that passage taken from Proverbs chapter 31, reading from verse 10 to verse 31.
Who can find a virtuous and capable wife? She is more precious than rubies. Her husband can trust her, and she will greatly enrich his life. She brings him good, not harm, all the days of her life. She finds wool and flax and busily spins it. She is like a merchant ship bringing her food from far. She gets up before dawn to prepare breakfast for her household and plan the day's work for her servant. She goes to inspect a field and buys it. With her earnings, she plants a vineyard. She is energetic and strong, a hard worker. She makes sure her dealings are profitable. Her lamp burns late into the night. Her hands are busy spinning thread, her fingers twisting fiber. She extends a helping hand to the poor and opens her arms to the needy. She has no fear of winter for her household, for everyone has warm clothes. She makes her own bedspreads. She dresses in fine linen and purple gowns. Her husband is well known in the city gates, where he sits with the other civil leaders. She makes belts, linen garments, and sashes to sell the merchants. She is clothed with strength and dignity, and she laughs without fear of the future. When she speaks, her words are wise, and she gives instruction with kindness. She carefully watches everything in her household and suffers nothing from laziness. Her children stand and bless her. Her husband praises her. There are many virtuous and capable women in the world, but you surpass them all. Charm is deceptive and beauty does not last, but a woman who fears the Lord will be greatly praised. Reward her for all she has done. Let her deed publicly declare her praise.
Amen. Amen. A woman of virtue, a woman of wisdom. You know, church, it's so important that we understand in times like this. You know, she gets up and laughs in the morning because she has absolutely no fear of the future. Hallelujah. That is what God wants you and I to have. As spiritual families, we don't have to fear the times that we live in. We don't have to fear about our children. Yes, it's difficult. Education has become so hard. Children are so stressed out. But you and I, we are blessed because we have God's word. And we see this woman, she was the husband's crown. She was bringing joy to the home. She is far more worth than rubies. She is priceless. That's what the Bible says. Because she receives the favor of the Lord. She works hard. She receives the favor of the Lord. She brings, for the family, she brings good, not harm. She does what she does, brings good to the family. She says she's clothed with strength and dignity. She's clothed with strength and dignity. Today, you and I, especially all you moms, all you ladies, remember, you have so much of authority and power before God because you are able to influence. You know, you look at this life. Only a short time, only 3 months, she was able to hide this child. And after that, she made a basket. And she put the child in the basket because she couldn't keep the child at home. And she put the child in the Nile because she had absolutely trusting God that God was going to fulfill his plan for this child. And God can do that for your child. For certain, if you trust him, even in difficult circumstances. And we know Pharaoh's daughter was bathing that day and she saw the basket. She took the child. And Miriam, who was hiding, the sister, she went and said, "Do you want somebody to nurse this child?" And she goes and brings the mother, Jochebed. And Jochebed, you see, looks after this child for 7 years. And then she gives back the child to the Pharaoh's daughter. But in these 7 years, she had such an impact, such an influence on that child, that that child became one of the greatest leaders that the world has known, that is recorded in the Bible. A person who was able to change the history. Today, your son, your child, can become a person who can be have a great impact. It's in your hand. It's in my hand. God has placed that child. We see in Hebrews chapter 11 and verse number 23, it says,
"It was by faith that Moses' parents hid him for 3 months when he was born. They saw that God had given them an unusual child, and they were not afraid to disobey the king's command."
Amen. They were not afraid. They had absolutely faith in God. They loved the child. And I know all you parents love your children. And you want the best for them. But they were willing to trust God, believe in God. They were not going to allow fear to control them. They were going to trust God so that God's purpose will be accomplished. You know, she not only nursed that child and cared for that child. Verse number 9 and 10 of Exodus chapter 2 says,
"Take this baby and nurse him for me." The princess told the baby's mother, "I will pay you for your help." So the woman took her baby home and nursed him. Later, when the boy was older, his mother brought him back to Pharaoh's daughter, who adopted him as her own son. The princess named him Moses, for the explained, "I lifted him out of the water."
Man. You know, moms, you all never get paid for your job. Moses' mom got paid for taking care of her own child. God blessed his child for that 7 years to be cared by the mother. But later he grew in a different environment. He grew among other gods. He grew in the palace of the Pharaoh. He saw violence. He saw hatred. He saw, you know, the villain that Pharaohs did, the bad things. He saw all that. When he was young, when he came to an age of understanding, he also thought those were the means of survival. He, in fact, when he sees a Hebrew being attacked by an Egyptian, he goes to, you know, stops that fight and he kills the Egyptian. That's how brutal he became. But you see the seeds that have been sown in his heart. The Bible says that when Moses was of age, he chose rather to suffer with his people than to enjoy the pleasures of the Pharaoh and the palace. He chose, he made a choice, because there was something that the mother had nurtured him to. You know, in Proverbs chapter 22 and verse number 6, it says,
"Direct your children onto the right path, and when they are old, they will not leave."
Amen. Train up a child in the way that he should go. And when they are old, they will not depart from that path. Direct that child in God's word. The milk that she gave was not only the natural milk. She gave him the spiritual milk, which is the word of God, which is the truth. Parents, listen. This is the most important thing that you should be doing during this time of lockdown. God has given us a great opportunity to teach our children the word of God, the truth. And the truth will set them free. Amen. This is what this great woman did. In Isaiah chapter 54 and verse number 13, it says there,
"I will teach all your children and they will enjoy great peace."
Amen. The Lord is saying, "I will teach your children and they will enjoy great peace." You know, none of us are perfect parents. We have made our mistakes. We have made wrong choices sometimes. But this is the new beginning. Today is a new day. Let's bow our hearts and say, "Lord, grant us your grace. Grant us your forgiveness." James chapter 5 and verse number 16. It says, "If we confess our sins, God is faithful to forgive us and answer our prayers." We listen to that verse and then I want to pray for God's blessing on your life.
Confess your sins to each other and pray for each other so that you may be healed. The earnest prayer of a righteous person has great power and produces wonderful results.
Amen. The earnest prayer of a righteous person. You want to see great things happen in your family? You want to see great results? Let's bow our hearts in prayer. Father in heaven, we bow before you. We thank you for your goodness and your mercy on our lives. And Lord, we thank you for this day that we have heard of this woman, Jochebed. Lord, the Jehovah's glory, she was able to bring your glory to her family, especially in her children's life. And I pray for every home and every child that is present today, that Lord, every family will, Lord, receive that glory, that Lord, reach out for that purpose, that destiny that you have prepared for them. Your plans are not to harm them, but to, Lord, to give them a great future, Lord, to give them success, Lord. And I pray for your blessing on every family. And I ask it in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. God bless you and have a great day.
As we heard God's word being brought to us today, I'm sure that many of you have been touched. And even as the Spirit of the Lord is working in your heart, whether you be the father, the mother, or one of the children, or even the extended family, I want to pray for you. If God has spoken to you, you have a need, you need to make a change, you need His strength, this is the moment when God will come and just envelop you with His presence. If you are one of those people who are standing in the need of prayer, then would you just place one of your hands on your chest and raise the other hand towards heaven as I pray for you. Father, we thank you, Lord, that we can come to you at any given moment, knowing that you are listening to our heart's cry, knowing that you are listening to our prayer. Father, even as we have heard your word, and even as we have been pricked in our hearts, and even as our needs have been opened before you, Lord, we pray that you would come and touch each and every one of us, especially those who have a hand raised towards you right now. Lord, whatever those hands represent, whatever need those hands represent, Lord, we know that you are the God of miracles, and we ask, Lord, that you would come and touch them, bless them, and work a miracle in those lives, we pray. Father, if there be a family that needs a miracle of healing, a miracle of unity, a miracle of peace, we pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, that you would touch that family, touch that home. Lord, if there be a home that is being attacked by the enemy, we rebuke the work of the enemy. We come up against the work of the enemy in the name of Jesus. We pray peace into that home, the peace of God Almighty. Now bless these brothers and sisters, bless these homes, bless these families, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. I trust that the Lord ministered to you through the word our senior pastor brought to you today. I also trust that God's peace is your portion. Would you bow your head as we pray and pronounce the blessing? I bless you now in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. I bless your home. I bless your family. I bless your extended family. I bless your neighborhood because of you. I bless your place of work. I bless your business. And I bless your place of education. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. Have a great week.